Blackstone presents Richard Wagamese Selected, What Comes from Spirit, by Richard Wagamese. This book is read by Christian Baskous. Introduction. Drew Hayden Taylor. I've come to understand that the pain of a wound or a loss is over as soon as it happens. What follows is the pain of getting well. Richard Wagamese. Another Richard Wagamese book for the public to enjoy. The literary gods indeed must be feeling benevolent. In the Canadian literary landscape, there exists what is known as the two Margarets, Lawrence and Atwood, two phenomenal writers who, it can safely be said, had a hand in the development of contemporary Canadian literature. You say, the two Margarets, and if you can't immediately name them and some of their works, well, it's time to hand in your citizenship. In the Indigenous literary universe, the same can be said about the two Richards, Wagamese and Van Camp. Anybody familiar with the stories coming from our communities will know those names. If not, time to hand in your status card. And also, I guess, your citizenship as well. But it is perhaps Richard Wagamese who has captured the Canadian zeitgeist best of all us Indigenous writers. His prolific outpouring of quality storytelling and his unfortunate death have cemented him quite firmly in what I, and to my knowledge nobody else, refer to as the contemporary Indigenous literary renaissance. Novels, poetry, nonfiction, he was a master of them all. If his name was attached to it, you knew there was substance behind it. He was an amazing writer, and more importantly, an amazing man. His smile was as bright as his craft. He was also one of those rare writers who always had something pertinent to say. That comes, possibly, from living such a complex life. Part of the infamous 60s scoop. Richard had a lot of life experience with the trials and tribulations of being an Indigenous youth in Canada to draw upon for his work. Add to that his eventual return to his family, people, and culture, and there was enough experience instilled in him for several lifetimes. 1,000 years ago, when I was taking my first infant steps as a literary storyteller, I wondered if I was doing the right thing. I had stories to tell, but I didn't know if I should be doing that. Back then, there weren't a lot of us around, and job opportunities for us First Nations dudes, writers notwithstanding, were limited. Fishing guide, heavy equipment operator, steel worker, and perhaps an actor on The Beachcombers. Then I happened upon a traditional storyteller just north of Manitoulin Island who took me aside and told me quite emphatically, "We need the new stories as much as we need the old stories." And that is how I have always perceived Richard, a contemporary storyteller, a word warrior, if you must, telling his stories to the world. His words helped the dominant culture to understand this generation of Indigenous people. They also helped us, I mean those same Indigenous people, to comprehend and appreciate the power of two things: the human mind, and a keyboard. Together, those two things can make all things possible. Richard's magical tales, in whatever form, had that power to change the world, and they did. The number of people whom I have come across who have been personally moved by his words, well, that would fill up a book in itself. His readers feel his pain and his joy, his confusion and his understanding, and they come away the better for it. Case in point, this collection of writings in particular, they are an assemblage of his thoughts, short pieces, and in some cases brief reflections gathered from social media. Idle thoughts that Richard shared with the world, gathered from his blog, newspaper columns, and Facebook account. There are over 2 decades of topics that Richard pondered about. In these pages, you will see his wanderings, his philosophy, his searching, and his delight at what the latter half of his life had provided for him, and how it reflected on his first half. There could be no better window.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.